Welcome back, everyone. We've been travelling down the coastline for many, many days, and we have not found a way across the water. And to be honest, I'm growing sick of horseback and therefore democracy.
Well, it's great. The horses are great.
Well, you seem to be having a great time because I think your horse is a bit more lively than mine. That's why you keep having to stop every half hour.
It says it's a cow.
I know last time we did the voting and we voted to go on horseback, but I've changed my mind. I think we should just go across the water. I don't like horses anymore.
Listen, this is the thing with democracy. You might not like the outcome. You're talking to a guy who voted against horses. I was pro-boat. I was the only pro-boat guy. But because I respect democracy, because I respect the people, I don't think we should ignore such a democratic mandate, and we should continue on horses.
Are you sure it's not just because your horse turned out by chance to be really good and I have a bad horse?
That's irrelevant.
Are you not allowed to change your mind in democracies?
No. Once you've made a vote, that one vote is permanently the choice, and that's it, and you're locked in.
Oh.
That's how democracy works.
Let me tell you a thing or two, right? Home is across the water, and we can't take the horses across the water, so we should be going on boat.
Well, you've taken the complete opposite position to when we left a few days ago.
So you want to stick with horses?
Yeah, stick with horses. You know, if we think maybe we do need to go across the water, then we just take the horses across the water. Horses can swim, right?
I don't know. Should we find out?
Yeah.
Onward!
Ha ha! Bad. Oh, horses can swim. In fact, they can kind of hover on water without even moving their limbs.
I guess they only evolved to be able to be buoyant with their own weight.
Yeah, you're sinking. Yeah, even the saddles might be pushing it.
Mm.
If they weren't wearing saddles, their little feet might be above the water as well.
They got mecha hooves as well.
Robo hooves.
That'll be contributing towards their weight. Well, what did they do in the past with horses? Because I've been led to believe that much of early Britain was based on horse.
Oh, yeah.
Hence horsepower.
Horsepower is huge. Although when you think about it, like if you had a car with one horsepower, that would be a bad car. The big way to transport horses was on boats. That's how horses got to America, for example. The ideal image of a Native American is like a kind of horseback nomad, but Europeans actually introduced horses. The Native Americans, as they were brutally pushed off their land by European colonists, they adapted to life on horseback, having had their land stolen. And then the Europeans were like, well, they were always nomads. Look how important the horse is to their lifestyle. There's a sheep down there. This is not horse country.
No. This is monkey country.
This is monkey country. We should be riding monkeys. Can you ride a monkey?
So that was experiment number one. Didn't work.
So let's try a boat. Can we get a horse in a boat?
Horse in a boat. Go. No.
Okay. Oh, I fell off. Cow, stop! He's gone mad. He's got horseitis.
All right, I'm on the boat. I'm under the cow.
Okay.
Horse.
Okay. Okay, it's working.
But are you in the boat or are you travelling along the boat?
I am travelling on top of you.
Okay, so let's see how long this can last then.
This is fine. This works.
Oh.
No. Maybe it's because it's you. Let me get in the boat.
You get in the boat.
Come on, cow. Come on. Cow. Oh.
It's not having any of it.
It was bad both times.
You all right? Would you like to find Lancraftshire? Help others, like and subscribe. Help and subscribe.
What if I just try to get in the boat?
Oh, there's a squid. Do squids go in boats?
No, squids hate boats. They regard them as intruders on their realm.
Let me see if I can push you out. Like a little tugboat. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Onward.
Away! It's working.
All right. See you back at Moleside.
See you at Moleside.
Just need a strong breeze. Put your arms out as like sail.
I don't know how to do that. Oh, he didn't like it. Oh, he's got used to it now.
How many knots did you get up to?
I don't know. None.
They used to tie knots at regular intervals on a piece of rope, and then they'd let that out into the water and count how many knots were dragged over per unit time, and that would give you the number of knots.
We should use that for everything.
Just small child in the back of a car letting out a piece of rope.
Yeah. Bring back Victorian child labour to measure knots.
I don't mean stirrups, do I? What are those like?
Yeah, you do.
No, the things...
The foot things with the stabby, they're like...
Yeah, they're...
It's like a little pain disc.
The stirrups are the... Like a pizza cutter. But no, the stirrups are the things you put
it's
your feet in.
It's a pizza cutter on the back of your shoe.
It's not called a stirrup. It's called a...
The stirrup... Oh, the stirrup is like...
The foot thing.
The thing that you put your foot into, like a pedal, a horse pedal, is what you're thinking of. Whereas, what's the stabby thing?
They've got a special name.
Aren't there weird ways of measuring horses?
Yeah, hands.
That's weird, because horses haven't got hands.
Like, one,
two, three, four. Wow, are we counting hooves as hands?
I don't think it's their hands, because otherwise they'd probably most of them would all be four.
I'm going to try. One, two, three, four. Ironically, four.
Mm. Four, well, there you go. And the thing is, I know it. I know the name, but I can't say it because I can't remember it.
Oh, I was worried it was like a really offensive word.
No, it's just, I just can't remember it.
if you can't remember a thing, then you don't know it.
No, I do know it has a name. I know it has a name. I can't.
Okay, so what's the next option if we can't get them in a boat?
Experiment number three. Remember minecarts?
Oh, yeah, I remember minecarts. They're fun.
Can we get a horse in a minecart?
Mm. Okay.
Do you want to ride a horse into that?
Ride a horse into it?
Yeah, yeah.
Here we go.
Oh, I think you overshot. You overshot. I don't think he's rooted into it, though, is he? He's just standing in it.
Oh.
No, that's you in a minecart. Spurs.
Spurs! Spurs.
Spurs. Spurs.
Spurs. Have we got spurs?
I haven't even got pants on. Just got a... What is this? Is this spaghetti? Maybe if you get off him... And then I push it into him. There you go. I'm thinking most boats, right, are metal. Let's face that, right? So maybe this is buoyant.
Our boats aren't metal. Our boats are wood.
You know what I mean, though? It's got a special name for boats when they smash that, like, Lambrini bottle on the edge.
A spur.
Christening of the boat.
Yeah.
All right, I christen you boat. Here you go.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Okay, Carl, we can do this. Okay, everything's going to be fine. Here we go. Back to mole side two.
Go. We can put the minecart in a boat. See that?
Whoa!
And then I can ride the boat.
Oh, you're all right. Fred, horses,
yeah.
Not only good for agriculture and being fast and cool, absolute badasses. You know the Mongolian Empire or the Mongol Empire?
What were they?
Genghis Khan and all that. Biggest contiguous land empire, as in like you can go from one end to the other and it's all connected.
Yeah, Disneyland.
Biggest empire overall is British Empire, but the Mongol Empire was absolutely huge, megatonk.
British Empire was an absolute nightmare for logistics, wasn't it? crumbly biscuit empire.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Little bits everywhere. They would have horseback archers. They could ride past you at speed, and they would be able to hang over the opposite edge of the horse and then shoot arrows at you from underneath the horse between the horse's legs.
Wow.
Okay, Fred, watch this. I'm going to Mongol horse archer, one of these animals. Which one shall I take out?
Chicken.
Here we go. Here we go. Yeah! Fred, did you see that?
Oh, I was looking at the wrong chicken.
No! The Mongol Empire rises again!
Our experiments with horse transports have been less than successful.
Well, I could die Mongolian horse archer to chicken.
That's true. However, that won't make you buoyant.
No, that's true.
I didn't want it to come to this, but I need to introduce you to the idea of the occult.
Fred, what are you talking about?
I'm aware of a way to construct magic shoes.
Magic?
That will freeze the surface of the water, allowing us to traverse the ocean horseback.
Horses don't wear shoes.
However, to acquire this occult magic, we do have to find a librarian who's prepared to sell us the spell.
Like at the village back at Moleside?
We'll have to look for another civilization.
You think there's other civilizations out here?
We rode through one.
That was a
What did you think all those houses were? Model village?
Fred, while we're packing up, where did we get all these leads?
Huh?
Where did we get these leads? We've got two for the horses and there's...
I'm pretty
sure you're using chickens to... do the tent as well. Ah!
I can't remember where I got these leashes from. You got that sword? Right, Donald.
Pack up the tent.
Yep, ready to pack up. Here we go.
Nice.
Hey!
Oh, finally! That was miles away. Fred.
Mm-hmm.
I've got an idea. I've got an idea. Follow me.
I've got Tobias leashed.
And then get in your boat.
Uh-huh.
And then... row your boat.
I guess this is a bit easier, actually.
Come on, Carl!
Goodbye, everyone.
We're going back to Moleside!